as we learn more and more about this virus, one of the things we've learned more recently is that people, you know, even up to a couple of days before they realize that they are sick, have the virus in their respiratory particles. So, you know, someone who may think it's very safe to be out and about because they don't feel sick may be spewing out some of these infected respiratory particles and then infect someone who's close by.
And so that's why if everybody wears a cloth covering when they're out in public or anywhere where they're within 6 feet of other people, then that will help reduce the chance that you could, without even knowing it, pass it on to somebody else.
You know, one of our nurses at Habif, her mother is a seamstress, and she's made us all lovely little cloth masks to wear when we go to the grocery store and go other places. So it's layered. There are several layers in here to try and give you some extra protection. The main focus is to be sure that you're covering both your nose and your mouth and that it's attached. So that's the cloth. That's the particular cloth mask that people often see people wearing out in public.
If there is somebody who's going to have a lot of interaction with the public and or patients in the hospital, what we use for their protection is to wear a surgical mask. Looks a little similar to the cloth masks, but it's made with a particular kind of material for medical purposes, and it's through medical supply stores and that hospitals buy from, and it is designed to provide a little bit of protection for the wearer themselves. Now, it also does a very good job of stopping, say, for example, if somebody's wearing this, it also does stop infection going to another person, but it is something that provides a little protection for the wearer, and it fits very similarly. You usually try to get a very tight seal around the nose so that there's no gaps around here. And that's what hospital workers use. And this is actually effective at stopping most infections within the hospital. There are some circumstances where there's higher level of protection that's needed. And one of the masks that I'm sure most everybody has heard of before is the N95 respirator. And this is really reserved for hospital workers who are taking care of patients with COVID-19 who are critically ill, and they're undergoing procedures that could spread the virus into the air in smaller particles that go farther distances. So this is higher level of protection, and it does fit a little more snugly and has no gaps in it, and it's a little bit harder to wear. But again, these are just used for those certain circumstances. Not even everybody in the hospital needs one of these.
And because they're cloth, you can wash them, you can reuse them, and use them as long as there doesn't appear to be, you know, tears in the mask itself. So this is something that once it's made, you can continue to use and reuse as long as you like.
That's right. And then some of the other masks, the surgical masks, for example, certainly can't be washed, and they can be worn for quite a long time because they're relatively comfortable. But certainly if they ever become wet or soiled, then they need to be discarded and another one is used, but certainly not the same idea of the cloth masks, which can be washed and reused. The most important thing to avoid being around other people that you don't live with within 6 feet of them. That is the number one most important intervention that we can do to protect ourselves. Now, the other things that we do as far as using masks for extra protection and hand washing is also very important as well. Those add additional benefits.
I think it's so true that such really simple measures are the most effective measures, and that everyone can do make all the difference.